Mario, you are one busy plumber. I mean, what haven't you done? Tennis, racing, golf, beating the snot out of your friends for no reason, and didn't you do that one game where you shoot the chickens with automatic rifles? No, that was someone else. But you do a lot of stuff, man. I mean, all these different spin-off games. I kind of feel bad for Sonic over there. I mean, you know, you've had your good times and your bad times as well, but Sonic's in a pretty low spot right now with Sonic Boom. You think maybe you could share some spin-off games with him instead of doing everything that you can imagine? I don't want to make it sound like you're being selfish, but sometimes it's good to share. Sonic Shuffle? That's right, Sonic, you've been copying Mario's spin-off game since the beginning. Get out of here! Yeah, sorry. Forgot about that. But to be fair, Sonic did fighting game first.
Why you do this, Sega? Mario did kart racing and then Sonic just had to try it out. Twice. Three times. Mario did punching each other, then 2 years later, Sonic... Oh, actually, 2 years before, Sonic did punching each other, so, okay, we're even. But then we're not even, because Mario did board games, and then Sonic did board games, and Pokemon cards! And don't even get me started on tennis. So Sonic's been following in Mario's footsteps for a long time now, but to be honest, why complain about that? I mean, the spin-offs that Mario does are great ideas, and being able to play similar games with a whole different group of characters is fine by me. Now, it'd be different if Sonic's games that copied Mario's games were better, but no, Mario still does them all best for the most part. Mario Kart is better than Sonic Racing games, Mario Party is better than Sonic Shuffle, and Sonic the Fighters and Smash Bros. Are two very different games, so in the end there really isn't anything to be too upset about. Now most of the time when Sonic copies Nintendo, they don't do it exactly the same, and hey, Mario didn't create kart racing games. But then there's Sonic Shuffle. This game is Mario Party. I'm sorry, but it's hard to tell the differences. There are a few gimmicks that Sega added, but in the end, you're still playing on a board filled with traps, with each square making you lose or gain a form of currency from the game it's based on, and your main goal is to find one special object that is randomly placed on the board. Every single one of those aspects is the same as the early Mario Party games. I think we can all agree that Sega was under the influence when they made this game. The influence of Mario, that is. So sure, this game's a copy if I've ever seen one, but is it better or worse than Mario's? Let's dive in. Not literally, as it's not a pool, it's a game. I'm sorry if you thought I was going to dive into the game itself. Can we start?
Now before we get into the game itself, the game's case is actually a lot of fun as well.
Just look how happy they all are with their Pokemon cards, and look at Knuckles with his smug little grin. He's like, I got a 5.
So Illumina, the guardian angel, gee, I didn't know even angels were a part of the Illuminati now, needs your help. The mysterious monster Void has locked the power of the precious stones. Precious stones, huh? Yeah, that's real adorable. Now it's up to you to guide Sonic and his friends through the incredible game boards to recover them. Oh, sure, yeah, so there's a story in this game. And I guess that's more than I can say for Mario with his role-playing with his friends to pick on Bowser. But you expect us to believe that Sonic and his pals have to play a board game to stop evil? I'm pretty sure you should take this a little more seriously. Also, the place in this game is called Imaginary World. it's all one word, Imaginary World. How do you come up with that? Was Fakey McFakerson land already taken? Oh, okay, Sonic is chasing a card. Oh, sorry about your string lady, and oh, okay. Oh, don't worry, I know what all this is. It's trippy. So here we are, on the main menu you can get right to the story or tutorial, but you can also go to Sonic Room. No, not Sonic's room, just Sonic Room. Gee, this sure is a Sonic Room. Here you can watch Tails act weird outside, and I'm guessing this is where you select things like mini-games and whatnot once you unlock them, so that's kinda cool, but we can't do that until we get the precious stones. Imaginary World. Let's do that. Select my character. Okay, I don't think they're alive, but I'll go with Tails. Oh, what the heck? Oh, Sonic. You possessed?
What is this place?
Knuckles is kawaii.
Who are you?
Oh gosh, Sonic, you did not just whistle at the female version of Knights. Which is basically just Knights.
It's no longer here. It was shattered to pieces.
Hey, don't cry. It's just a rock.
The precious stone was stolen by the darkness of Void.
Oh, so he didn't steal it, just his darkness did?
Alright, yeah, I get ya. I hear ya.
Let's do it!
Well, I've got nothing better to do.
Of course you don't, Knuckles.
Here we go!
Now wait, Sonic, that's a lake! So now we play the game. It's odd because in Mario Party, Mario and his pals are competing to be the superstar most of the time, but in this game, Sonic and his pals are supposed to be working together, yet they still try to kill each other in the minigames and stuff. So this game is based on cards rather than dice like in Mario Party, hence why I call it Sonic and the Pokemon Cards. But why Pokemon cards? Are all cards just Pokemon cards? No, of course not, because you battle Pokemon. No, seriously, this could not look any more like a Pokemon, and so do most of the bosses. Okay, so we beat the boss, we got the Precious Stone. No, come back, Precious Stone. What? The next stone? You said we needed to get one, you liar! Also, hi, Eggman. Oh, jeez, Amy's down, call an ambulance. She just got 19 tons dropped on her. I think that's like 5 elephants. Okay, cool, now we get to play a minigame. This is always my favorite part of Mario Party. Oh my gosh, why are we in a tornado? You have to collect rings while falling to win because, yeah, if I were in the eye of a tornado, that's what I'd be worried about. I gotta say though, the minigames in Sonic Shuffle are a lot more skill-based than Mario Party. Maybe not always as fun, but one issue I always had with the Mario Party minigames was how most of the time the game's winner was completely random, so no amount of skill or practice would guarantee you a win.
No, Sonic, no.
No, Amy, don't be happy. Be sad. Your friends just drowned and you left them to win a stupid game. Eggman, much like Bowser, wants me to choose what he uses to hurt us. Okay then, thanks.
This is what I'll do to you.
Ew, don't say that ever again. No, I'm being serious. Don't do it.
No, not the beam. Not the beam.
Oh. Well, that was pointless. Knuckles, why are you doing this to us? And while you're at it, what are you doing to us? I have no idea what this is.
Accident? Tsunami! This is just madness. Almost all these minigames are. Forget Mario Party when you do boring stuff like picking flowers. We get to ride tornadoes and dodge tidal waves.
Oh, cool. Oh, cool. Oh. Well, that's not cool. Sonic, just stop, okay? You stink at this. I have to agree with Shadow on this one.
Your shoddy craftsmanship brings shame on all hedgehog kind.
Whoa, giant Eggman. Come on, Knuckles, you got this. Nope, you messed up again. Oh, okay. I guess Knuckles throws a ring in a lake for some reason.
Is that all you got?
Yeah, dumb lake. Is that all you got, a stupid gem? Okay, Sonic, fight the fish! On skates. Sure. Oh, Sonic's dead now too. Bummer. More Pokemon! Not again! Amy's lucky to have survived the first one. Hey guys, let's take a selfie in space! Yeah, okay, great job, guys. Good work.
Sonic, why you do this?
Oh, Eggman, no, don't do that, please! Amy just runs away. Yeah, good call there. He already dropped 38 tons of lead on you. That's all you need from him today. By the way, what's going on with these numbers?
Ah, now it is my turn to pointlessly kill my friends.
All right!
Ugh, Tails is excited.
Oh man, no, I'm sorry. I don't like this. No, I'm sorry. Why am I doing this?
Hi, fishy. Flat fishy. Now there are a few random games like this one where you have to launch Eggman into space forever. Serves him right for dropping tons of weight on people. Wait. Oh wait. No, there's no air in space. He's in an open cage. There's no windows. There's no air in that ship. Wait, bring him back. No. Amy, I don't even care anymore. If he doesn't kill you, one of us will. So big whoopty flipping do.
Oh, holy mother of pearls, what are you doing to us?
Take him down, men. No, Amy.
Curse Opal. Annoy other characters? What? Am I gonna make like a dumb sound or something to bug them? Sounds like kind of a pointless thing to do when Sonic turned giant and killed us. I don't know if annoying them is really worth it. Oh no, Eggman gave me a power-up. He's so evil. What the heck are you guys doing now? Died.
Honestly, I don't even care anymore. I'm not even trying. I've been playing this game for 2 hours. No, literally 2 hours, and I haven't gotten past the first stage, so I refuse to care. Wait, what? Eggman, are you putting me right next to the stone? I love you, Eggman.
Now let's get this over with.
Well, not before one more minigame, of course. Oh my gosh, Knuckles is literally cooking us over an open fire. No, what the heck? Stop! Why is this such a violent game?
Oh, for the love of all insanity, it's over. I beat the boss. Now get me out of this ice zone. The heck is happening now? Oh, tsunami surfing. Okay, cool.
No, Amy!
No!
Sonic! What are you doing, Knuckles? Cut it out.
Okay, we beat the darn stage. In a total of 2 hours and 30 minutes.
Stop! This is a world! A world of everyone's dreams!
Okay, well, who cares what that was? We are done. I'm done. You're done. We're all done. So this game, I mean, it's fun if you're doing multiplayer and the minigames are always good, but the story takes way too long. The boards get boring fast, and like I said, in multiplayer, it's a great time, but single player is just not stimulating.
So in the end, I don't think this game's too bad, but it would be a lot better if it had just the concept of multiplayer and minigames without the long, boring board to play on. Kinda like...
...40 party games for up to 4 players.